I said, oh shit. Well, I would, but I don't even know her. She's just some friend of a friend of somebody that I used to be. Well, she's new to New York, and I told her that I can't. What if she's some big dud and we all have a miserable time? Exactly, you all blame me. Give me 30 minutes, tops.
Yes? It's Sarah, and—
Oh, come on up.
Hi, you're Callie.
Yes.
I'm Sarah. This is Caesar, and I can't believe you're doing this.
Oh, come on in. Have a seat.
Some apartment.
I was cleaning.
It's huge, and the neighborhood.
You can't be comfortable.
Oh, I am.
Are you sure?
Very.
Let me just get rid of some of this stuff. Oh, coffee?
Would be great. Listen, this is so nice of you.
Oh, no. I was thinking about getting a cat anyway. Oh, my keys. Well, this will give me a chance to see if I can hack it.
That's how I feel about New York.
Oh, yes.
How long have you been here?
11 years.
I've lived in St. Louis my whole life. My parents live like 20 minutes outside. I go there for dinner when it's not even anybody's birthday. Things there, it is so
easy.
So easy.
It's hard here.
Good. Great. I can't wait.
So, what do you do?
I teach, third grade.
Shouldn't be hard finding a job here.
I already have one.
Oh, where?
P.S. 32 in the Bronx.
What was the school like that you came from?
Society of Friends. Quakers.
No, I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing around.
It's obviously very... But I can do good work there.
I'm sure you're a great teacher.
No, you don't know, but I am.
So, where in the Bronx?
Tremont.
Oh, Tremont. Is that near... Taft, is it Taft?
Taft High School?
Yeah, you heard of it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there was this teacher there, this rich
white guy. Yeah, I know.
And he got killed
by a student. I'm hearing a fellowship set up in his name.
Oh, how long's the fellowship?
2 years.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you.
Best of luck, and if it gets too rough, go home.
So what brought you to New York?
College.
And what keeps you?
Keeps me from what?
What do you do?
I ruin things for everybody else.
You're Rudolph Giuliani?
I'm a traffic reporter for a 24-hour news radio station.
Helicopters?
The inbound lane to the Holland Tunnel is closed due to a car accident. The Brooklyn-bound lane to the Westbury Bridge is under construction until 2002. The D train is not running because of a track fire. You can't get in, you can't get out, you can't get around. I'll be back in 10 minutes to tell you that nothing has changed.
Does that ever get to you?
Well, it's a job.
How long have you been in this apartment?
5 years. Well, two by myself. It's a funny, not ha-ha kind of story.
It's okay.
Well, I moved in here with my boyfriend, Tom, and it was his aunt's apartment. We lived here about 20 years. She lived here about 20 years.
Your rent must be
lucky.
You are.
Well, I got the apartment and he got my sister.
Oh.
Well, it's perfect. They live in LA now and it's perfect.
Well, at least, I don't mean to be crass, but...
Yes, no. Well, I love the apartment.
It's as big as mine and I share it with two other people.
Oh, did you move here with either of them?
No, they came with the apartment. They're a couple. It's kind of awkward, but he's sweet and she's sweet, and they seem to have a
sweet
relationship. They're fine.
It's awkward.
Rents are so... Everything is...
It's impossible to live here.
You love it.
You know, Sarah, I've actually been to St. Louis, and it's a quaint, pretty city, but... What's the point? I mean, people still have their cars all geared up with their car alarms, their clubs, and their computerized keys, and they have to drive across town to get to all the good, cheap places to eat. I mean, you're in a city and you have to drive.
Where did you grow up?
Tiny town upstate.
Industrial?
Countrified suburb. Tractor display in the middle of the mall.
Pretty though?
You know, I can't connect with nature and the furry little animals. They snub me. You know how you can be in a room with two other people and you're all having a great time and then the person next to you says something in French and then they both have a big laugh. Best laugh anyone's had all night, and you're left out because you took Spanish in the 7th grade, not French. Well, that's what nature does to me. It speaks French to the other people at the table.
I hate jazz.
You do?
I don't usually say that out loud because then people think I don't have a soul or something, but I don't like the way it sounds. I don't like saxophones.
My sister played the saxophone.
I'm sorry?
I hate my sister.
The one who,
yeah.
I hate your sister too.
Oh, so do your friends think you're crazy?
Forget it. My parents and Peter. My ex. I mean, I went there every weekend. I came home every weekend when I was in college.
Close family?
It's a cult. It's embarrassing. I should have moved. I mean, you were what, 18?
Oh, don't look at me. I was all set to go to one of those colleges that advertise on matchbook covers. My guidance counselor filled out my application to NYU.
I had to interview 5 times to get this fellowship. And by the 4th, I had a rabbit's foot, rosary beads, crystals, a tiger's tooth, and a Polynesian tiki all in my purse. Now that I have this fellowship, I have every god to pay. What should I ask it?
Something whose answer you won't take too seriously.
Was moving to New York a good idea? It's sort of stuck between two of them.
That means yes.
I should go. I'm taking up too much of your time.
Listen, if I hadn't told some friends I'd meet up with them,
you should have said.
Oh, no, no.
I didn't mean to.
Listen, what are you doing this weekend?
I don't know. I'm packing, but I've got to do something New York-y, don't I?
Well, why don't you come over and I can take you around the neighborhood, show you some nice, fun places to go and eat?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you could spend some time with, is it Caesar?
Caesar! Ah, forgive me. He hates being in this thing.
Oh, let him out.
No. He may be a little shy at first in a new place with a new person.
Oh, you know, you could come and visit him if you wanted to. Just let me know. I hope that you feel...
Thanks, Callie.
For nothing. For what?
Was he coming on to you, trying to pick you up?
He's just saying stuff. Guy stuff. Stupid.
What did you say?
I wanted to leave.
Your girlfriend?
My friend, Sarah, said something.
What did she say?
Leave us alone or something.
And that's what set him off?
Well, yeah. She said, but then he said something back and she told him, she said something upset him.
And that's why he wanted to punch him? That's when he grabbed her away from you?
He punched her in the back, and then he grabbed her away.
Punched her in the back with his fist?
I was holding onto her hand with my hand like this, and he came up behind her and punched her in the back, then he grabbed her away and started banging her head against the building, and then he started smashing her head against his knee like one of those wrestlers. That's when she lost consciousness. And then he smashed her again.
And this was at Bleecker and West 11th at Little Park?
Yes.
At 4:15 in the morning?
Yes.
What were you doing there?
Just walking around.
Which bar were you at?
Excuse me?
4:15, honey. It's closing time.
Well, we had been... We were at the White Horse Tavern.
The White Horse Tavern on Hudson Street?
Yes.
Was there a good crowd there?
Yeah. Pretty crowded.
Did you talk to anyone?
Just to each other, mostly.
What did the bartender look like?
Excuse me?
Bartender.
It was a man.
Short, stocky guy, salt and pepper hair?
No.
Kind of tall, skinny guy with a receding hairline? I know a couple guys there.
Sarah ordered the drinks. I didn't get a good look at him.
think he was tall?
I'll go talk to him. Could be somewhat suspicious acting noticed, or the bartender might have noticed someone suspicious acting that you didn't, or something that he would have seen that you didn't.
The bad guy was tall.
The bad guy, what did he look like? Tall.
He was big, sort of like he worked out.
Was he black?
No.
Hispanic?
It was dark.
Short hair, long hair?
Short, maybe dark brown.
Anything that he was wearing, do you remember?
He was wearing a leather jacket, jeans, boots of some kind. He was 20-something, maybe mid.
Like a college kid, frat boy?
No.
Like a punk?
No.
Like what then?
I don't know.
Any name or symbol on the jacket? Any markings?
No.
So, he sees a couple of good-looking girls walking. Were you drunk?
Not at all.
One of them a line, she tells him to fuck off, and he beats her into a coma. Anything else you want to tell me?
That's what I remember.
Doctor done with you?
I think.
Alright then, I'm going to ask you to come with me right now and look at some pictures.
Can you bring them here?
No, I need to take you there.
Because my friend...
They say if she's out of the woods...
But if she wakes up...
A for effort, but no. Indonesia, Micronesia, Australia, Malaysia.
So basically all the countries that sound like skin rashes.
Peter said, what about anesthesia? Speaking, what time is it?
Just about 6. Why? Hmm.
Well, Peter called around 6 and left a message saying he wanted to come and visit. He manages a restaurant in St. Louis, and he wants to come and check out some of the cool places around here.
You better hurry.
Well, I couldn't make it in 15 minutes.
You could if you took a cab.
But then I wouldn't have Vietnamese food.
We could do it another time.
I just started this beer.
One waste of beer.
That's what I was thinking.
Cheers.
Clubs and bars there.
They even have ones for straight people.
Is that why you live there?
My husband and I have a beautiful apartment, Detective Cole, in a safe building on an otherwise quiet street. The fact that it's Graceland for gay people doesn't matter to me.
So, what were these two girls doing? Were they making out, rubbing up against each other, or?
I didn't see anything until I heard the other one screaming. I went to the window, then I called 911.
What did you see then?
He was beating on the both of them. I yelled down that I called the cops, and then I threw a couple flower pots at him. My spider plant.
So the screams woke you up?
I was in bed, but up, reading.
At 4:30 in the morning?
I'm a fitful sleeper.
You ever take anything?
No.
So you weren't groggy or half asleep?
No.
And you're sure you heard him call them dykes?
I'm sure.
And your husband? Your husband?
He missed all the excitement.
What, did he sleep right through it? Oh, he wasn't home. What is he, a fire chief?
No.
Investment bank?
Ha.
Doctor?
He's a book editor, Detective Cole.
I didn't know book editors worked so late.
They don't.
Was he out having drinks with somebody?
He was obviously out, wasn't he?
You called 911, and then what happened? He screamed. He called 911. Oh no, you screamed and then you threw your plants. Then what happened?
They fell.
The flower pots fell near him. He stopped and went away.
And that's when he called 911. Well, you stopped him.
Well, it wasn't the cops. It took 30 minutes for them to show up. You'd think it was Harlem, not the West Village.
Thank you.
right.
So, you're all right, huh?
Yeah, I'm fine. What?
Oh, no, I just haven't heard from you for a while.
I'm fine. Busy.
Lydia called. She said she got that book you were looking for, but she never heard back from you.
Oh, I forgot.
She got that job, you know.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, she's pretty excited. A bunch of us are going out Friday, so try not to be fine, but busy that night, okay?
I put it down. George,
I know. We can watch your show. I just want to check the score first.
No, it's not that. I have plans for tonight.
Oh, yeah? What?
I'm meeting a friend for dinner.
You have a date?
It's not a date.
With who?
It's not a date. I told you. I'm meeting my friend Sarah for dinner.
Who the hell is Sarah?
I told you. She's that friend of a friend of a... She's new in town. I'm taking care of her cat.
I thought you said she was a big loser.
I said she might be. I didn't know. Now I do. She's not.
So what is she?
Huh?
What's she do?
Oh, she's a school teacher in the Bronx.
So she's a nut.
There's something wrong with us.
Why?
Because that's what I thought when she told me.
You have to wonder about people like that. What do you want to do? Give a kid a chance? Save a life? Or just feel good about trying?
It's a fellowship. She competed to get this job.
To teach in the Bronx? What do the losers get? You don't ask who it is anymore?
It's her.
You thought that was me when I buzzed.
You're right, that was a mistake. Now you really have to go.
Why?
Because I have to go.
I'll walk you out.
But I'm not leaving yet. Hey.
Hi.
Oh, here, these are...
Thank you.
They're babies. I was just going to go throw these away. Hey, did you see they're filming a movie or something on the next block? Do you think we could stop for a while on our way to the restaurant and watch them filming?
It's NYPD. Didn't mean to scare you.
No, you didn't.
I'm George.
Oh, George. I've heard so much about you.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, sorry. Sarah, this is George. George,
can we get
is
this?
Oh, okay. We should get going. Our reservation's at 8.
Where are you going?
Mom.
Dressed like that?
I didn't have
no,
time.
No, you look great.
Thank you.
Well, tell me what you get.
Have you ever been?
Out of my league.
Oh, is it expensive? I don't want
it's not expensive.
You're treating? And I want it.
You still owe me for my birthday.
Let's just go Dutch, Kelly.
It's my treat.
Well, okay. Nice to meet you. Bye.
Tell them why we're going tonight.
Apparently, we're celebrating the fact that today one of my students, LaChandra, wrote her name for the very first time.
I'm changing.
That's right. You're a teacher.
Mm-hmm.
Kindergarten?
Third grade.
This kid wrote her name for the first time?
Perfectly.
Isn't that...
wonderful?
Isn't it?
Okay, we should get going. Our reservation's at 8. Do you think we can stop by the NYPD?
Sure.
See you later.
Well, don't you want to come with us?
Mm-hmm. I think I'll catch it on TV. Never take me to Vaughn.
Hey, thanks for coming in. You want some coffee?
Thank you. Fine.
We were talking about the White Horse Tavern last time, right?
Yes.
On Hudson Street?
Yes.
I told you I wanted to go in and talk to the bartender, right? To see if they noticed someone you didn't.
Yes, you said.
Well, I went in and I talked to Stacy, and she said she doesn't remember you coming in that night.
It was pretty crowded.
Do you remember telling me that the bartender of the White Horse Tavern that night was a tall guy?
Sarah ordered the drinks.
So you didn't get a good look at the bartender?
I didn't.
Not even enough to tell if it was a girl or a guy.
I'm sorry.
this guy says something.
What did he say?
Something like, hey, you want a party?
And what did you do?
I didn't.
Did Sarah say something?
Yes.
So she's what set him off.
What?
Well, I mean, if she said something, so that set him off, right?
If he hadn't started...
Because if she hadn't said something, this whole thing wouldn't have happened, would it?
He started it. He...
All right. He said something. He said something, and that upset Sarah. So, what did he say?
He was bothering us.
Did he call her something? Did he call her a name?
No.
What's a name that upset her?
I don't know.
How about bitch?
No.
He didn't call her a bitch?
I don't...
A pussy-eating bitch?
No.
What did he call her then?
He called her
say?
A fucking...
Say it!
Fucking dyke! Pussy-eating dyke, both of us.
Now, why would he call you that? Two nice girls sitting on a park bench talking. Why would he call you dykes? Pussy-eating dykes.
Because we were kissing. It was the first... We didn't know he was there until he said something. Hey, save some of that for me. Sarah told him to leave us alone. I can't believe she... Then he offered to pay us, said he'd give us $50 if we went to a motel with him. He said we could dry hump or whatever we like to do. Turns him on just to see it. I grabbed her arm and started to walk away. He came after us, calling us fucking dykes. Pussy-eating dykes, both of us. Sarah told him to fuck off, I couldn't believe. Then he came up and pulled her away. I yelled for someone to call the cops. He punched her in the back, and then he pushed her against the building and started banging her head against the building. He told her to watch her cunt-licking mouth, but he had his hand over her jaw. She was trying to breathe. I came up behind him and grabbed his hair. He turned around and punched me in the stomach. I puked and it got on him. Sarah tried to run away, but he grabbed her and started smashing her head against his knee. I tried to grab his arms, but he was stronger. He knocked her out. And then he turned around and kicked me to the ground and kept on kicking me. Someone yelled something. Cops are coming. He took off in the opposite direction, west. He was limping. He hurt his knee. That's what happened.
From the bottom instead of the top.
I hate that.
Do you change it or leave it the way it is?
What do you mean change it? You changed someone else's toilet roll?
Yeah, if I was gonna use it a couple times. Okay, your turn.
Say you're driving down the road and you see a pothole up ahead. What do you do? Straddle or swerve?
Straddle.
You
straddle.
Swerve.
Nuh-uh. Yes, you would.
Cat in the road.
Caesar. Say a rabbit.
Okay, a rabbit. What do you do? Straddle, swerve, or brake?
Straddle a rabbit?
A sports utility vehicle. Four-wheel drive, you could.
Screech to a brake, check the rabbit, then smoke. You?
Brake.
Swerve.
Why do you keep saying that?
This is you.
These cards are driving me nuts.
Come on, one more hand, please.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah, of course.
Why did you want it?
You mean this fellowship?
Public school teaching the Bronx.
As opposed to private school teaching St. Louis.
Well, that's what you're used to, isn't it?
Well, it's where I worked for 5 years. I never got used to it. I never went to private school. We all went to the cruddy public school. Well, I mean, it was cruddy compared to the private school. It's the Sorbonne compared to where I teach now. But these kids, what am I giving them? They're more than everything.
And the Bronx?
Okay, those kids.
was when I was their age.
I was the kid who had the right answer. Knew I had the right answer, but would never raise my hand, hoping that the teacher would call on me anyways. Those are my favorite kids to teach, and here, now, I've got a classroom full of them.
Did you pick up another card?
You should come and meet them one day.
Yeah, okay.
I'll bet you've never even been to the Bronx.
I go every day.
Fly over.
That's more than most New Yorkers.
Can I ask you about your job?
Go ahead.
Why the traffic?
Why the traffic indeed?
As opposed to news reporting or other kinds of journalism.
I am not a journalist. I've never worked in TV or radio before I got this job.
Then how did you get it?
My boyfriend Tom, his uncle worked at the station.
Oh.
I mean, it's the traffic. It's not even the weather. I just fly around in a helicopter all day and tell people what the cars are doing.
But the helicopter part is pretty great, right?
Yeah, how great.
Well, if you don't like it, you should get another job.
I can't. I don't get that.
What time is it?
2:30?
Already? Is the subway okay this time of night?
You should take a cab.
Well, how much will that be?
About $10.
Well, I'll take the train.
I'll give you the money.
No, I have it. It's just too much. It's 4 or 5 steps.
Listen, you can... You know, you're welcome to... I have another bed. You can stay here until the morning when it's safe to take the train. I'm not getting up for anything in particular.
Maybe Caesar will come sleep with me.
Yeah, you can reconcile with your cat.
He's holding such a grudge. He never comes out when I'm here.
It only took him a few days to sleep with me.
Lucky.
Here, let me just, I think it's comfortable. I never laid in it myself because I live here. But if it's not comfortable, we can switch rooms. And in fact, why don't we just do that? I'll sleep out here and you can sleep in my room.
No, this will be fine.
Sure.
Would you just come lay here for
a
second? Just, you know, since he's been sleeping with you.
Of course. I guess we have to pretend we're asleep.
Oh, right.
Okay.
exactly what drink I was making the moment I heard your name on the goddamn TV?
No, I don't.
Dirty Martini. TV's on in the background. I hear about this gay bashing, two women attack, and I sort of pay attention. Not really. So I'm making this drink, and I'm thinking about how I gotta go downstairs and get some more peanuts. And then I feel like my ears close, and my face gets all hot, like I just swallowed a mouthful of hot peppers. So I turn to the TV, but now they're talking about some apartment fire. So I change the channel, and the story's just getting started. Gay bashing, woman in a coma, Cali packed.
Not in a coma.
What?
Sarah's in a coma.
How do I know that? How do I know anything when I hear on the goddamn TV?
Would you want me to call from the hospital?
Yes!
What was I supposed to say? On a payphone, in the hospital, Sarah lying in the next room, face swollen and blue, cracked open, barely responding to anything but the barest reflex, all because...
Come and get me. That's what you could have said. Are you hurt? Did a doctor look at you?
Sarah's hurt.
Nothing happened to you. Callie.
Bruises.
Where? Let me see. Let me see.
Nothing to see.
You want me to call anyone?
No.
Want me to spend the night?
No.
Do you want me to go?
No. George, do you remember the first time we kissed? Want, Callie. Finally, I let her know. I answered.
Their families don't have cars. I don't have a car. Nobody I care about has a car. Who am I helping?
People with cars.
Who are they? Why do they live in New York City when they hear on the radio every 10 minutes that the traffic is so bad?
Maybe you should look for another job.
Oh yeah, whose uncle's gonna get it for me this time?
You could get a job based on your experience.
As a traffic reporter?
All right, well, what do you want to do instead?
I don't know.
All right, come on, we can think about this. What do you like?
I don't want to do this.
You know a lot about food, you have great taste in restaurants.
I really don't want to do this.
You could become a chef. Like, go to cooking school.
What was your plan for your daughter?
You obviously have some kind of talent for food.
I'm not going to cool, let's go.
God, what is that smell?
I think someone downstairs is trying to cook something.
You think that smell is related to food?
Very.
It's really starting to come down out there.
That means it's going to be really hard to get a cab.
Well, we still have time, don't we?
Not really.
We can be a little late, can't we?
Sarah, I asked you to be here at 5:30.
I know, I'm sorry, I just lost track of time.
Let me send it to the radiator for a second.
Is that what you're wearing?
Yeah, what?
Nothing.
I mean, is this a dress-up event? What are you wearing?
Just clothes.
Let me see.
It's just what I wore to my hippie friend's wedding.
Let me see. Oh, you look great.
I'm underdressed. We don't have time for you to go back to your place and change.
Can I borrow something of yours?
Forget it. I don't even want to go.
I thought you had to,
technically.
Isn't your station getting an award?
They are. I'm not.
Okay, so let's go. Why are you still sitting down? Let me see what you've got in your closet.
Could I wear this?
I wore that to a reception last week.
You did, I didn't.
People will recognize it.
Do you care? Kelly, what the hell?
I don't know.
Okay, just tell me. What do you want?
I have to go to this thing.
Do you not want me to go? Is that it?
You don't have to go if you don't want to.
Kelly, will you say what you want?
I have to go to this thing. I have to.
So let's go.
What are you going to wear?
What?
Well, I don't want you to go dress the way you are, and I don't need to wear some of my clothes. What will people think if we walk in together and you're wearing my clothes?
I'm not going.
Now this.
I'm tired, I'm underdressed, I'm not going to know anybody there except for you. Forget it.
Sarah, I asked you to go to this thing with me a week ago. What? I told you it was an award ceremony. Why'd you dress like you were going camping?
Well, you didn't make it sound like it was that big of a deal.
An award ceremony?
Well, if you wanted me to get dressed up, you should have told me.
I asked you to be here at 5:30. You couldn't manage that.
What's the big deal? You don't even like your job.
I don't like my job the way you love your job, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't show up the time I asked you to, wearing something appropriate.
Well, obviously this is more important than you thought it was gonna be, and...
There's my cue.
I'm Phoebe.
Yeah, go.
Get chased out of your own apartment again.
What?
Better to plan your life around someone else's schedule than to face them and tell them exactly...
What do you care? What do you care?
Kelly.
Fuck it, I'll stay right here then.
Perfect.
You can
Anita and Joe are in there now. Yeah.
They're strict about that at the hospital. Two at a time.
Noah's Ark.
Excuse me?
Two at a... Stupid.
Did you... How was your flight?
There were like six peanuts in the hole. Flight was fine. Fine. Thanks.
Her parents are... How are they?
Anita is wrecked, and Joe, they're... I mean, Sarah's their only daughter, and...
I know.
They never wanted her to come here. The doctor says she can't be moved until she regains consciousness.
They want to move her?
Mm-hmm.
Back to St. Louis?
To Chesterfield. It's about 20 minutes outside where Anita and Joe live.
But what if she doesn't want to go?
Why wouldn't she?
Because the fellowship, she worked so hard.
Her old school would take her back in a heartbeat.
Her old school, but she...
But the doctors don't even know when she'll be able to go back to work. Or if. The doctors can't say. There could be permanent... She'll need rehabilitation. Maybe home care.
I know.
She needs her family, and they need to take care of her. There was a response.
Excuse me?
Sarah. The doctor said she responded to... He asked her to squeeze his hand, and she squeezed.
She did?
Yeah.
She did!
Fucking A.
Amazing! Thank you. Sarah told me nice things about you. So many.
She didn't tell me about you. She said you were a friend.
I am her friend.
And that you knew good restaurants to go to. That's all Sarah told me about you.
I see.
Sarah and I...
She told me.
We lived together
yeah,
for...
No.
I still...
Yes.
I'd like you to tell me what happened that night. Please.
Sorry.
What?
I can't.
Why can't you?
Everything you need to know has been in the newspapers, on the TV.
I've seen the newspapers and the TV.
Then you know
everything. No, I don't know everything. I know what time it happened, I know where it happened, and I know that you were there. And now you're here, and Sarah is in there. That's the part I want to know. Why is she in there?
I wish it was me, but it isn't.
Why isn't it? Were you hurt?
You don't know what fucking happened.
Tell me. Why couldn't you protect her?
He was big. He was stronger. I tried.
How big?
I tried.
Bigger than me? Could I have... Was he bigger than me?
No.
Why was she protecting you?
If you were a dog, you'd do it. Hey, George.
What? Did you just call here? Why not? Yeah, Vaughn was great. I got the sea bass with cardamom, and Sarah got the grilled lamb chops with coriander. Yeah, she eats meat. Why wouldn't she? I don't know what you're talking about. Listen, what are you doing for dinner? Because I just walked by Tomo and noticed there's no line. Come on, I need a sushi fix. All right, if you get there first, just tell them. I know you know. Okay, bye. Okay, Caesar. Second chance.
Dear Park.
You can't tell.
It tastes like plastic.
You want Evian? You got it.
It's not Evian. Vermont Natural Springs.
It's Deer Park or Dos Equis, George. That's what I got.
Dos Equis, please.
Got any snacks?
I think I have some wasabi peas.
Those green little...
Tastes like sushi.
Oh, shit!
What?
Someone's birthday at work. A bunch of us are going out to this Japanese tapas place on 9th Street.
Oh, come on, blow them off.
I can't.
Come on, we'll go get breakfast in the morning at Abby's. And have pancakes.
I made these plans before you called, Callie.
Whose birthday?
This new girl at work. I don't think you've met her yet.
Let me guess. She's an actress.
She's classically trained.
You really need to get out of the restaurant business, George. Broaden your dating pool.
Listen, I'll call you Wednesday, right? Jasmine, she's having everyone over for dinner.
Yeah, I put it down.
Bye.
And they didn't want me sitting around all summer doing nothing, which was true. And I had to take these tennis lessons, but I'm a klutz. And I tried, but I'm a natural klutz. Still, at the end of the year, we all had to play in these tournaments against kids from the other classes. And sure enough, first round, I get matched up against this girl who obviously took tennis lessons because she wanted to be a really good tennis player. The match takes like 10 minutes. I can't even return her serves. Afterwards, my parents feel so bad they can barely speak. They take me to Dairy Queen and tell me to order whatever I want,
So I get the triple banana split, and they leave me alone all for the rest of the summer and let me watch Love Boat reruns, which is what I wanted to do anyway.
That's a good show.
But lately, I feel like there's something worth winning.
Kelly, I know neither you or I have ever really, well, I never really asked you.
Oh, I did get an award, by the way.
What?
An award for traffic reporting.
Who knew?
Are you serious? Oh, I'm sorry. I interrupted. What were you saying?
You knew you were going to get that award, didn't you?
Huh?
Is that why you were so...
Oh, I swear I didn't know.
Did they call you up to the DS and everything?
Just like the Oscars.
I wish I had seen.
I wish you could have, too. Do you want to see it?
Yeah.
I think I stuck it in over here.
Sometimes I find things in here. Is this it?
There it is!
Put it over here.
Oh, no, not there.
Why not?
Everyone will see it.
Exactly.
But stop it!
But I mean it!
Any good news?
Her, she's stable.
I guess that's good news.
Her bruises are healing.
Yes.
Can tell she's a pretty girl.
Yeah.
She's a school teacher?
She is.
Where?
In the Bronx, third grade. She has 35 kids. She knew all of their names by the end of the first day.
It takes a lot to be a school teacher in New York City.
She's got it.
Those kids are lucky.
They know it.
I'm gonna give her bath.
Oh, all right.
I'll show you so you can do it.
Oh, that's very, but I don't think I should. I've never...
You won't upset me. You've seen the worst of her. Most of her bruises are on her face. Her body looks fine, if that's what you're worried about.
I don't know if she'd want me to.
You won't upset me. I'm sure she'd like it better if you did it.
Right now, though, I have to go. The time, but thank you.
JFK.
At 11?
11:30. Have the car service pick you up at 10:30. Tell the driver to take the BQE to the LA to the Van Wyck. That should get you to the airport at about 11. But tell them to take the Midtown Tunnel back because the Manhattan bound traffic on the Williamsburg Bridge will be too heavy.
Check. Do you ever go out dancing?
Sometimes I do. My friend Sheila likes to go to this club on Wednesday nights, and sometimes she invites a bunch of us girls to go.
I'd like to go sometime.
Sure.
Will you let me know the next time you go?
It's fun. A bunch of us girls know, and it's fun. The music's great. You don't have to worry about guys trying to pick you up, because it's all women. I like to go there to dance, because there's this warm... Like when you're waiting for the bathroom, there's only one line and everyone's really nice and smiles.
Have you ever asked someone to dance?
We stick together mostly as friends. Sheila knows some of the women there. I've met them.
Have you ever met a woman that seemed interesting to you?
No. Not there. Have you?
What?
In St. Louis, do they have you been to?
Well, we have a couple places like that, but I've never been. My friend Janet says that only college girls go to the clubs and bars. Older lesbians just stay home and read. That's what everyone in St. Louis does. Stays home, brews their own beer, does their email.
But, I mean, have you ever...
Well, I mean, woman who's never felt attracted.
Right.
It's just that if you've never actually been.
Would you like a beer?
Love one.
I hope I have some.
What time is it?
Just about 6. Why?
I promised my roommates I'd go home and clean the apartment before they got back from their trip, and they're going to be home in an hour.
Just wait a couple more minutes.
I really should
just go. Just wait one more minute.
Why?
I want to show you something.
Callie.
Here, take your watch. What time is it?
5:59.
And how many seconds?
38 seconds.
And what day is it today?
Thursday.
And what time is it now?
5:59 and 50 seconds.
So count them.
What?
The seconds. Count them down. 5 seconds.
4, 3, 2, 1. What? What? Oh, it's quiet. It's Thursday at 6 and it's quiet. I'll call you tomorrow.
Okay.
See ya.
Okay. Bye.
When I first moved here, I'd smile at strangers on the subway, give quarters to beggars on the street.
Is Sarah goes to dawn.
So I can imagine what it must have seemed like to her. Small town girl in the big city, seeing men dressed as women, women holding hands. It must have seemed like gay paradise to her.
St. Louis is not a small town.
She's at St. Vincent's, isn't she?
Yes.
How are the doctors there? Are you pleased with them?
It's hard to say. You want them to do everything. You want them to make her better, but they do what they can. They're all right.
How do you find it spending all your time there? I know they have limited visiting hours, but they probably let you stay all day.
I have a job I have to go to.
Of course, I didn't mean to.
But I do go every day.
It must be exhausting for you.
Well, her family's there.
Are you close with them?
No.
Not
close.
I know what it's like with in-laws. It took years before mine. Have you and Sarah been together long?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were.
I know.
So you're not.
It's
really...
all right.
So you're not really...
No, but like I said, I do go every day.
But you're not really involved.
Just a little strapped because business was slow last night.
Just don't think about it.
Brought $50.
Oh, that'll get you a salad.
How expensive is this place?
Expensive.
Why do we have to go to a place like that? Why can't we just go to Benny's Burritos and drink a bunch of margaritas?
I told you, I'm gonna pay for the whole thing, so stop stressing about it.
Okay, Miss Traffic Reporter of the Universe, or whatever you are, I'm going to have the lobster.
They have venison.
Ooh.
Does this dress make me look fat?
I cannot and will not ever answer that question.
I'm changing.
Why are you so uptight?
I am not uptight.
That's the third time you've changed. Who is this guy anyways?
Sarah's ex.
Why do you have to look so good for him?
It's a nice restaurant.
Is he gonna be dressed up? You told me I could wear jeans.
Well, that's because I knew you would wear jeans anyway. So, How was the birthday party the other night?
Fine.
Did the birthday girl get everything she asked for?
You want to talk about this?
No.
Cool.
So, did you fuck her before or after midnight?
Nice.
I'm just wondering about the technicality.
Listen, I'm not like you and that guy. Who was that guy? With a nose ring?
Hey.
In the bathroom with no protection?
I told you that!
I asked.
We should start keeping more to ourselves.
Too late.
Don't say that!
Why is that?
Makes me feel old.
We are old.
You are. Hi!
Hey, how's it going?
Where's Peter?
He left. You look beautiful. Oh, how are you, Georgia?
He left New York?
Yeah. I told him to tell the driver to take Van Wyck.
Did something happen at work?
No, I asked him to leave.
Listen, we don't have to go out.
Yeah, no, if you're upset.
No, I want to. I want to get to know George better.
Are you sure? I mean, we don't have to.
He was just being so... He was judging everything. Your apartment's too small, it's in a bad neighborhood, and your school is dangerous. He just wouldn't stop talking about how dirty and dangerous everything is.
Well...
It is.
Compared to what? St. Louis? I don't want to live there. I've started something here, and it's because... Well... I love New York.
Well, let's eat!
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Great! Let's go!
I'll catch up with you.
They have venison, you know.
You mean Bambi? Yes.
And then 98 kilometers, that's 61 miles, north of Locania is a lunar landscape. That looks lunar, doesn't it? Some of the locals don't mind showing off the interiors of their white-walled subterranean settlements. You'll want to sign up early for that tour. As I was saying, looping around about 160 kilometers, that's 100 miles to you and me, a road leads to Mutwinyi, a surprising patch of greenness in the barren Benguano. Australia is an English-speaking country, isn't it? Look, I'm just dying to see how this ends, but can we... Thank you. We'll save the big finish for after dinner. Hey, did you see this? You got a card from your old class of friends. See, there's Matthew and Sophia, and Emily, your favorite, the Antichrist. She writes, "I hope you feel bitter and come bark soon." I see your replacement has been letting her spelling kids spell something. Oh, hey, look at you! Oh. I've been talking to Jenny and Steve a lot lately, keeping them updated. Jenny's been letting everyone know what's been going on. Margaret's called, Jamie, Lisa. It's frustrating for them not to be able to see you. They picture the worst. All they have is the images in their heads from reading newspaper articles. It'll be better for them when they can see you. The doctor says we can move you soon. I've been talking with your parents, and I agree that you should stay with them once you get out of rehab. You're welcome to stay at our old place, of course, if you want to. I would take off from work so that I could... I'm gonna take off from work anyway. Just because you're coming back home, I'm not gonna act like everything's going to be the way it was. I know you went to New York because you wanted to change things. You do want to come home, don't you?
Excuse me?
You're back.
Do you have time now?
Yeah.
To show me how to do it?
Thank you.
by the West Village. Henrietta's. Have you ever been?
Once.
Will you go with me?
Like this?
We could change. Friday night is supposed to be a good night.
Okay. Good for what?
There's supposed to be a lot of people there.
Yeah, okay.
You change, and then we can stop at my place, and then we'll go.
We don't... You can borrow some of my clothes.
That's better. That's great. You change first, and I'll change next. I'll wear whatever's left over.
I'll go change.
Maybe we'll like it there.
Yeah, okay.
Let's just...
We'll go, hang out, have a drink.
Yeah, you know, maybe meet people.
Are you... I mean, do you want to meet people?
Yeah. No, I want to meet people to maybe make friends, but no, I don't want to meet someone, some stranger.
We'll just go.
It's just a bar.
Whole bunch of lesbians in it.
And us.
Sarah?
I brought you some stuff to change into. Don't you think?
Right. We're gonna do this. But you have to listen to me, okay? And you gotta watch me too. All right, we're gonna start with the left because we're taking things off. And now the right.
Can you go like this?
Oh, good for you! I should tell later.
All right. So far, so good. Is this a nice shirt? Did I pick out a nice shirt for you? I'm gonna need you to sit forward a little for me, okay? So, like. Oh, Sarah, am I hurting you? Oh, I'm sorry. Relax. All right? This side you can do, okay? Push, relax and push, and it's a girl! Cold in this place. All right. We gotta do this together, all right? So I don't do this one, and you can do that one, okay? Oh, okay. You need to help me with this one, okay? Are you helping me? Yes, you are. All right, Shoes go last. Like this. And like that. All right, I'm gonna need you to stand up now, but I'll help you, okay? All right. Ready? All right, one, two, three. Do this, see? Choose me.
Yeah.